This is the feature confrontation. It is for the World Tag Team Championship. It is set for one fall with TV time remaining. Introducing in the ring from Minnesota, total combined weight 532 pounds, the Minnesota Wrecking Crew number 2. And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents from Detroit, Michigan, total combined weight 525 pounds. They are the World Tag Team Champions, Rick Steiner, Scott Steiner, the Steiner Brothers.
They are the Detroit Bad Boys, Lance. That's what I call them, man. The Detroit Bad Boys, and they're bad. We're going to see some bone-crushing action here, I think.
You better believe if the Steiners are in there, it'll be bone-crushing action. These guys are what I call neon athletes, without a doubt. They just shine so bright above all of the other stars in there. They have excited all of the wrestling fans and are holding on to those world tag titles. We'll see how they fare against Ole Anderson's rugged crew of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew 2.
Well, you know, besides the fabulous Freebirds, I'll tell you what, there's not a tougher team than the Steiners. I'm impressed. They know all the moves, and they're bad.
Oh, that's right. I was supposed to mention again that you're world championship caliber.
Right,
and
right.
You're looking in there for the
right.
Next time that the match
Sure, I'm ready. I'll stay ready. I'll wake up ready, go to bed ready. I'll sleep ready.
I know about that. Well, I'm ready to show you up, too. I'll tell you for a fact. Look at the Steiner. Scott in there in action as he is the younger of the Steiner brothers. And the Wrecking Crew is switching out. Pounding away on that shoulder. And you know, they have been trying ever since Scott had that arm hyperextended. They've been trying to get at him with it, but so far he's been, look at this! Him up on a reverse atomic knee, and Rick Steiner rips with a right hand. Scotty dumps him up and dumps him down.
Well, you know, it just shows good ring savvy on the part of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, because they pick a weak part of the body and they concentrate on it. You know, I was thinking about that concert. You wouldn't believe it. 112,000 screaming fans. It was hard.
Wild is right, as Scott Steiner was nailed from behind just in the event while you were talking there. You missed the other Wrecking Crew member. While Scott was looking at the legal man in a ring, he got glommed from behind and put him down. Yes, he did.
I missed that.
You missed it. Goodness gracious. Well, I can tell you one thing. The Steiners didn't miss it, and they won't forget it.
For sure he would have had a three count there, Lance.
He was close to it until the other Wrecking Crew member got him from behind. Now it's all four of them in the ring. In the air and down. Scott with a Steiner line, followed by Rick. And both of them know how to do it. What a pair of champions.
I'm amazed.
Referee is over saying to Rick, don't you think you belong outside the ring? Not as long as there's two of them, I don't belong outside the ring.
You know, they're almost good enough to be Freebirds, Lance. I swear, they're almost good enough to be Freebirds.
There's no handling.
I'm going to have to ask
Jimmy
them about
Jam.
That. I'm going to have to go up to them one day and ask them how they'd like that, you know.
Oh, Rick Steiner caught looking. He was getting down low to make a charge. Crew member came zipping across, got a one count. That's all he could manage out of that. He lift, follows right up on the ropes as the referee steps in, tells him to get him off. Whoa, he didn't have time. Hello, how are you? Wham!
You know, I think the harder you hit that Rick Steiner, the more he likes it and the tougher he gets. That's the only thing I can figure out, because I've seen people dish out some pretty stuff medicine to him, and he still keeps coming back.
He does indeed, and he knows when to make a tag to brother Scott, and Scott follows right in behind. Oh, talking about a knee lift. He caught him wide open, drilled him, and the Wrecking Crew not having a very good goal at the Steiners in this particular action. Scotty rushed back in the corner. Maybe I talk too soon.
No, well, you know, they are World Tag Team Champions, and I guess, you know, if we have to have somebody to present the great NWA, it couldn't be anybody.
sent back out, while the other Wrecking Crew member won't let the referee alone. Hammers Rick. Scott on the ringside, run into the ring post and the arm again. There they are, working on that arm, Jimmy Jam.
Well, you know, Scott Steiner has no business out there on the floor. He should be in the ring wrestling like he's supposed to, but no, is he there? He's outside trying to stir up
trouble. Just how do you think he got out there? They threw him out there.
They're a little clumsy, them Steiners. That's the only problem with them. Every once in a while, they get the notion they just kind of fall out of the ring.
Double
out of the ring like a fish or something.
Flop out of the ring. Your brain flopped out from between your ears, I think. Scott Steiner, double axe handled and whipped into that corner and being held back so that they can't take Brother Rick and make the tag. And Scotty up in the air on the shoulder. Look out now. Oh, drill that shoulder down with all the weight up above on the shoulder. Got a two count, but he kicked out of it. Scott started the wrong direction in there. Rick's not going to wait any longer. He's tired of what's going on in there. And the referee cuts him off. And Scott being choked over that top rope. Come on, ref. Oof.
He should be quiet. He shouldn't be asking the referee for directions home in the middle of a match. I mean, is that any time to be asking for directions or something like that? I'm sure that's what he was talking about. I think I heard him.
You know better than
something.
That. Scoop slam and Scott down with the arm and a hammer. Trying to work his way back up. He has on his mind getting over and tagging Brother Rick. He took it all the way back over. Beautiful as he got him. By the rope, though, he'll never make the tag. I mean, never make the pin there. Too close.
But that was a beautiful reversal, though, you have to admit.
Yes, it was.
He did a fine job of getting out of that.
Amazing he has that strength to be able to do it, but these guys are so powerful.
Well, they train all the time, you know. They're always in the gym.
Maybe that's the reason why they still have the belts. And in the ropes, the Frankensteiner down on the mat. Scott trying again to get to his brother. What an incredible move that Frankensteiner is. Full 360 power slam once again from the outside.
Once again, in comes that other Steiner. I don't understand why he don't stay out where he should be. He should belong out there and just leave his brother alone or something.
Holding Rick in the ring as Rick ducks under. Knocks the Wrecking Crew member over. Look at him, belly to back. One, two. Steiner, hold on to the belt.
The winners and still World Tag Team Champions, the Steiner Brothers!
Well, there it was, Jimmy Jam. Not only the combination of great wrestling, but look at this.
Here you see the Minnesota Wrecking Crew going for something that didn't quite work, and what they ended up in was a great belly-to-back by Rick Steiner, and that's definitely a 1-2-3.
We've got some more words for you. Be back in a moment. Take a listen to this.